In a small subgroup of women with low functional ovarian reserve, DHEA supplementation does not succeed in raising testosterone levels. And that is not surprising because we know of a number of genetic effects where the metabolism of DHEA to testosterone does not work well. Most of these defects are found in women of African descent. In those women where we do not see that DHEA supplementation raises testosterone levels and gives us the testosterone levels that we are striving for, we have no choice but to give testosterone directly. Now, giving testosterone directly is obviously always a choice, but we prefer to give DHEA because it's a more physiological way of supplementing androgens, because that's how the body does it. If we give testosterone to a patient, her whole body gets swamped with testosterone. But our organs, our individual organs, require different testosterone levels. So the liver has a different testosterone level from the ovary. If we give DHEA, then every organ takes up as much DHEA, the precursor, that it needs to convert to testosterone. And therefore, there are fewer side effects. That does not mean that in those few cases, and it is probably around 5% of the total population, when we have to give testosterone, that causes tremendous side effects. But there are more side effects with testosterone. And more importantly, it's much less convenient because testosterone is applied on the skin. You give it by gel. And there is a much higher risk of contamination of children if they touch by accident their mother's forearm, etc. So it's more complex. And therefore, clearly DHEA is the better option if it works.